Let's talk about Hillary Clinton, who is obviously way favored on the Democratic side of the aisle. You said that the political world had lost its mind about the Hillary Clinton emails. You don't think that this is something the American people should care about? She wiped her server clean. She used a private server for official business.
No, I don't mean that it's not something that should be looked at. I think it is. But my point was, when this all happened, every political prognosticator and pundit was saying this was going to be an existential threat to her campaign, some said. And we have a poll for out in Iowa last night or the other night that said that she's still doing quite well there. So I think it's a legitimate issue that people should look at. I just don't think that it is the threat to her long-term political viability, some say it is.
One could argue that the reason that she's been able to avoid any harm from this is that she has avoided any questions about it. She has really kept the press at arm's length during all of her various trips. She hasn't given any significant interviews. Is this a smart strategy, or do you think it ultimately will backfire?
Well, I think over the course of time, it's important to remember she hasn't even done the official announcement of her campaign yet. Over the course of time, she's going to have to engage with the press, and they will be critical to her success. I think that whenever you're in a situation like this, as I was when I was running for President Obama, you want to make sure that you run your campaign strategy, and don't do it on the schedule the press sets. But what you can't do is go so long without talking to the press that it bubbles over into a world where every single little interaction you have becomes, carried on live television. And so you've got to find that right balance. As the campaign goes on, I think they're going to be able to do that.
But I guess, some of the questions, she doesn't want to answer questions, for instance, about the Clinton Foundation, about whether there were, or not whether, about why there were violations of the ethics agreement that the Clinton Foundation entered into with the White House. You remember this. When she agreed to become Secretary of State, there was a very intense negotiation, and a lot of those arrangements were not adhered to by the Clinton Foundation. That's a fair question to ask about. Also, she hasn't really come out and stated her position on this Pacific trade partnership that a lot of liberals like Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren oppose. There are substantive questions that she's avoiding that I don't understand why just putting them off until she has to do them makes it any better.
Well, look, there are no questions. Those are legitimate questions, and she's going to have to address all of those and a lot more over the course of this campaign. She's probably going to have to do it sooner rather than later. She's going to have an announcement in a short while here, and after that, I suspect that her engagement with the press is going to have to increase. But if she doesn't answer those questions, that will hurt her in the long run. I'm not sure it has yet, but in the long run, you're going to have to take those on, or it will add up over time.